And here we are, on this lovely day in the neighborhood. But you're expecting Mr. Rogers, forget it. Yes, today we're going over the rainbow. It's around 10:45 a.m. as we begin our westbound trek. We'll be using Interstate 70 as far as Frederick, where we pick up US 340 for the trek into West Virginia. One place we'll be seeing is Cool Springs Park. It's about 219 miles. They've come about 37 so far. You don't have to see how far we have to go yet. Once again, crossing Pars Ridge. We might be over the ridge, but we're not over the rainbow quite yet. But we do have some distant mountains. Done a day Odyssey in quite some time. Hope I didn't forget how to do it. Hope I didn't lose my touch. Well, you're about to find out. Now coming into Frederick again. We've now come 57 miles, but up here pick up US 340 westbound towards us, West Virginia. Maybe we're heading towards West Virginia, but this route crosses state lines several times. You'll see. Now we're ascending Catoctin Mountain. In the distance, South Mountain. This four-lane highway was completed in 1967 to replace the old two-lane road. It was parallels to the right about a half a mile. But soon we'll see the old road, a part of it. But here we exit to pick up the original 340. Original US 340, now MD 180. I got off onto this road for a reason. To get some special effects. That's why. But there is one more reason we took this road. And there it is. Gotta make a pit stop. I can time for some time-lapse photography. And there's our time-lapse back on the road. Around about 12 noon right now, give or take. Still on original 340. And entering Knoxville. Yes, we have one too. To the left, CSX. But up ahead, we merge back onto the modern day 340. Oops, the merge area, back at you. Up ahead, our Potomac crossing, where we begin crossing state lines. Well, first crossing to Virginia. underneath this bridge is the old 340, the CSX line, and the C&O Canal. Near the end of the bridge, we're in Virginia officially. Because the shoreline is the state line. But we'll just be here for a few seconds. We'll be crossing state lines again. And here we go. Officially in West Virginia. While I go opening the door, all of a sudden everything turns into color. Pretty cool. Open the door and there's the color. I like that. Never thought of it myself. Wow. We must be over the rainbow. Crossing state lines yet, though. We'll be crossing state lines a couple more times on this trip. But first, passing through Charlestown on the original US 340. We got bypassed about 30 years ago. But back on the original route here. Right there, the courthouse, where John Brown was tried and hung. I love saying that every time I pass here. Of course, John Brown, the Civil War abolitionist, who began the Civil War, who began the events leading to the Civil War. They all knew who he was. John Brown began the events leading to the Civil War by killing a black porter on the B&O train in Harper's Ferry and trying to start a race riot by doing that. It worked, but the ride became a Civil War. Not close enough. Got to hang a left here, hold on. And departing Charlestown. But up here, back to the modern day route. These lanes will soon end. And again, we're back to the original route. Original two-lane highway. Off the beaten path again, finally. It's been a while. This run has special meaning for me, because back in 1958, my father came this way on his way to Tennessee. My father often spoke about this road, often at time. Up in 58, he came this way going to Tennessee. Maybe thought he was going there when he passed through Knoxville, back to where we just were, and got fooled. Oh well. Now he made it all the way to Tennessee. He went all the way. But up here, a place called Ripon. Zip code 25441. Old gas station there. I recall when those things ran, believe it or not. Yes, indeed. One of my father's favorite roads. And mine, too, consequently. This place has been here for a while on the right. My pappy's place. fact, up around the bend, we crossed the state lines again, back to Virginia for a while. I pick up four lanes. These two lanes are original. The two that were added on later on, in the early 80s. Up ahead, we pick up Virginia Route 7, westbound for a while, as far as the Winchester area. We're using this route because it's a traditional route from the 80s and 90s. I thought we'd always come this way. At Winchester, we pick up US 50 westbound. And now we're approaching the Winchester area. But we're going to bypass Winchester on I-81. Another route as well. Temporarily north on I-81. Because we get off here to pick up US 11. We're taking US 11 as far as VA 37. Not temporarily south on US 11. Here, picking up Route 37 south as far as 50. There you go, our itinerary. It's a little after 1 p.m. right now. We come up for 109 miles here in Winchester. There are the stats so far. US 50, our westbound route. We will see Romney. We pass through Romney in a bit. And this is US 50 west, which will be on the next few hours. But up ahead, gotta make one more stop. Gotta do the pit stop thing one more time at this here store, which I've been stopping at for 20 years now. Also, I gotta get out and stretch my back for a bit, make a therapeutical stop. Keep playing with some more time lapse. Look what I found in there. Route 11 chips. We were just on that road a little while ago, Route 11. They got their own chip brand, how about that? Nice car there. We stopped at our store. Right up here is the other store. We've only been in there just once. Hotspot will be Gore, because there we will see the Winchester and Western line. That's where they're headquartered, in Gore, Virginia. We're about to cross it right here. Winchester and Western. I'll soon stop and check it out in downtown Gore. Now back on the original Route 50 and entering Gore. The current 50 bypasses this. I can see why. Not much happening here. But up here, hang one more left so we can check all this out. Everything's different here. They tore down the original shop. It was right there. When I first entered these locos back in 2013, I couldn't tell if they were EMDs or alcos, but a bunch of you left comments saying they're EMDs, so I guess that's what they are. The line once continued west to Wardensville, West Virginia, but now truncates about 3 miles down at a quarry. She's doing her thing too, but over there, either a calf or a slug. Calf or slug? What is that? This way we're looking east, back towards Winchester. Don't stray too far. She's straying too far. I was just here in 2013, but by then the original shop was still there. Now it's been torn down. As I said, that's where it was, right there. Stop barking, you dog. I'm trying to narrate. Hate when dogs bark and I'm narrating. Anyway, the new shop's over here. Not as fancy, but I guess more modern on the inside. Oh well. We have to tear down the old history in favor of modernity. Never fails. All right, everybody, stop barking. I'm out of here. We're now back on the road. Back in the modern day, US 50. Still heading west. But up here, back to the original two-lane road. We'll soon cross state lines again, back to West Virginia. And up here is where that happens, crossing state lines one more time, back in West Virginia. We'll be here for a while now. Saw it. Just crossed Bear Garden Mountain. Not descending. Near the bottom, we enter Cabin Bridge. And here's the bridge at Cabin Bridge. Across the Cacapon River. Next mountain will soon ascend. And part of the old 50 over there. But I'll keep it here for simplicity's sake. Now ascending. Almost at the top. This is known as Saffernacker Mountain. Remember that spelling. You'll be quizzed as soon as I'm qualified to give quizzes. Whenever that happens. I'm not qualified to give quizzes yet. Schaffernacker. Up there, our next mountain. And now ascending it. In fact, the one time, the road took a wider swing there. Old road over there. I recall when the road still ran over there. Before they relieved that curve. Came back out right here. Back in the 90s, you can see cave entrances on the right there. But some of them got plugged up. I've been looking for them ever since. But there were some caves there at one time. Yeah. I keep saying, I like the old stuff better than the new stuff. Here's Route 29, going north, takes you to a place called Paw Paw, West Virginia, by the Sino Canal. Our next hotspot will be Romney, but first gotta pass through Augusta, or Augusta, however you say it. There's a spelling. Let's see, Cool Springs is 219 miles, come 145 so far. So again, there are some stats for you. Do the math, 219 miles is minus 145. But up ahead, we arrive in Romney. But up ahead, I'll turn right to check out a train station for the first time, where the Potomac Eagle runs. I showed you the Potomac Eagle back in October 2015 on a rainy day, but you're about to see where it departs from. This is Route 28 going north, which goes to Cumberland, Maryland eventually. Just arrived at something here. That's a track. That's an XBNO line there. Also going to Cumberland. This way goes south towards Moorfield. And there are trains. That's the one I showed you back in October of 2015. On a rainy day. I thought there'd be a classic train station here, but there isn't. Just the trains. Oh well. I was hoping for history, but I can't win them all, I guess. At least something's here. The Potomac Eagle. Approached that train about a year and a half ago. Here it is now, just sitting there. Just sitting there, static. Nice locomotive, though. One day I gotta get out here and ride that thing. And back on the road. I'm about to regain US 50 westbound. not shortly after 3 p.m., you come 154 miles. I was going to get that out. The thermometer back there said 91 degrees. Doesn't quite feel like it, though. Maybe like humidity or something. All right, departing Romney. And the pier crossing of the South Branch. The Potomac Eagle's route. It will come out of the right and go to the left. On its way south to Moorfield. And the pier, we pass through a gap in this mountain. There was a quarry there at one time, but apparently it shut down and grew over. Back in the 90s, it still functioned. And a bar for the quarry workers. They even had their own bar. But still, strange, a lot of stuff that once ran no longer runs. And the quarry back there right up until recently. We're talking 90s, not 40s or 50s. A lot of stuff the past 20 years went out of business. I can't explain that. But at one time, these U.S. highways were referred to as interstates before the coming of the expressways. That's the story I got from my driver ed teacher back in 1971. Once on these roads were called interstates because they got to other states on these U.S. routes. Approaching another one. Interesting there. The former interstates. Now passing through Burlington, West Virginia. When I worked at the video store, I had a customer who lived way out here. He lived way out here. Came to Baltimore to see me. I told him, I know where you live. Whatever. People come from way out here just to see me. How about that? They drive 165 miles just to see me. Old stuff along here. I love looking at old weather stuff, old weathered buildings. Very videogenic. Is that a word? Videogenic? Up sharp curves, back at you, and out to ascend our next mountain. We're going through a gap up there. Here's the gap. Interesting how they put these roads through many years ago. This was the best they could do at the time. Over all these mountains. And more up ahead, which we'll also cross. Yep, that one way down there too we'll cross. First, come look for a certain road. Gonna pick up 220 North for a bit to look for a road called Hershey Hollow Road. Because we used to always go that way. Keep north on this road, it'll take you into Kaiser, West Virginia. We're about to cut off when we come to Hershey Hollow Road. There it is. Back in the 90s, I take an occasional back road like this, like Hershey Hollow Road. That's how I found this one. I just took a chance on it. There are some old stores along here with old signs I'm trying to find. Nice old houses though. Kept up just enough. Don't want to keep it up too much. Keep it looking nondescript. Right down there, a couple old signs for you. Just like American Pickers on History Channel, they go for stuff like that. Those pumps or whatever else. They'd have a great time back there if they came. Up here, back to US 50 again. That-a-way. Another old house there. Don't know if you can restore it, though. And more sharp curves. Nice stuff along here. Nice covered bridge there for someone's driveway. Nice outhouse back there. And keeping on 50, you guessed it. Miles before Cold Spring Park. On the left, Dolly's Place. Well, Fuller Place. Her name fell off the sign. The first two letters fell off the sign. Yes? Folks do live here. Even this far out. We are far out. Always have been. And again, more hairpins here. I'm telling you, driving these roads is a challenge. Not for the faint at heart. But before the expressways, this was it. Like it or not. I like it. Winding up the mountain. After a point, it gets boring, all these curves, believe it or not. I've still got the curves. And now the top of the mountain. Or almost. Okay, now we're at the top. There's an overlook up there that we'll stop at and overlook the area. I stopped at the overlook at the top of the mountain, where it's a bit windier than at the bottom. To the right, to the south, you will see Saddle Mountain. Right there. The story behind that is it's the birthplace of Nancy Hanks, Abe Lincoln's mother. Yep, Abe's mom was born there. Nancy Hanks. I forget when that was though. way back when, early 1800s. But that's where she was born. So there it is. History at the saddle. We'll soon pick up US 50 again, continuing west this direction. That-a-way. I'm back on 50 again. These aren't the main roads anymore that people travel. They're not considered main roads anymore. But on the bright side, they're more peaceful to travel now as a result. Way more peaceful. But now we have expressways. Don't be fooled by that. We have a long way to go before coming to that. Believe me. Another 25 miles before Cold Springs Park. But before getting there, we'll cross back into Maryland for a few minutes. Again, do some state line crossing, just for a bit. South 42 splits off. Route 42 south, that's what I want to say. It takes you towards Canaan Valley, a vacation spot. Of course, people do go both ways. We're going this way. Some bikers here showing off, taking advantage of the empty road. Need I say more? I don't want to say any more on that subject. But here we begin our descent into the Potomac Valley. Again, we're going to recross the Potomac in a bit. But again, those hairpins. Anybody need any hairpins? Got plenty of them out here. Out here, got plenty in stock. The bottom of the grade in a place called Gourmania. But up ahead, our Potomac crossing, we're back in Maryland. As of now, back in Maryland. Just crossed the Potomac again. But here, the Potomac is just a trickle. Very narrow here at this point. Not much to it. And this is Gorman, Maryland. Gorman and Gourmania. Sounds like an 80s movie title or something. Gorman and Gourmania. Like Victor Victoria or something like that. Movie title. So, back in Maryland, but we're nowhere near home though. That's a ways away. But in about 10 minutes, we're back in West Virginia. Now crossing Backbone Mountain. Door stores appear that are still in business somehow. I'm surprised. Some stuff's still open out here. Here by Backbone Mountain. Now we're in Garrett County, Maryland's Great Northwest, which did a video on last year, 2016. Do you recall that one? I brought you out here. And I bet we approach Red House on Route 219, which goes north and south. North goes to Altoona, PA. South Elkins, West Virginia. Someone once told me someplace here there was a honky-tonk or something. One of these old buildings. A honky-tonk somewhere. Back in the day. Back in the 40s or 50s. When honky-tonks were the in thing. What's honky-tonk anyway? But back then, a lot of stuff once occurred. Back in the 40s. A lot of outlaw stuff or something. A lot of outlaws back then. Including someone named Junior Knotts, Don Knotts' cousin. He got busted back in Garrett County for a crime spree or something like that. Then Don just had to get away from the guy. And so, Barney Flav's cousin used to cause trouble back there at one time. How about that? And of course, as we all know, Don Knotts is from Morgantown, West Virginia, originally. I'm north in Morgantown. That's where he was born. But back in West Virginia, as promised. See, I keep my promises. And if you keep on this road long enough, you'll end up in Sacramento, California. But that's where this road ends, Sacramento. Another 2,500 miles, give or take. We're not going quite that far today, though. Sorry about that. Passing through a place called Aurora, as in Borealis, which I've seen before a couple of nights. Nice house there. Nice architecture there. But I like the old stuff still. Cool old stuff. That's got like an overhang there on the second story. Interesting the way they built things back then for overhangs and things. They don't do that anymore these days. But all trucks must stop and check their brakes out before descending down the grade. I guess that makes sense if you're a trucker. Here comes the downgrade. We're descending down to the valley of the Cheat River. This road's got more curves than every lady I ever dated put together. On the bottom of the grade, finally. And again, very peaceful. And up here, we cross the Cheat River. on 72, takes you to Rollsburg. I go this way, takes you to Cold Springs Park. But as I said, people do go both ways. The south goes to a place called Philippi, West Virginia. But okay, friends, we're almost there. And here it is. After a 4-year absence, we're here. Cold Springs Park. A busy place today. We made it. Now for obligatory look around. If you're an American picker, like those guys on History Channel, this is the place to be. This is the kind of stuff that pickers go for. With that brand of tractor right there, for one. Hope they're watching this. I watch them, they should watch me. An overshot wheel there. And now it's overshooting. It's actually functioning. Check that out. Back in 2013, it wasn't spinning. And more old stuff that somebody might want to pick. Yours for the picking. Got some old trains here, but nothing runs though. But over here, a couple of narrow gauge tracks, oddly enough, with a narrow gauge hopper. But over here, an upside down steam tractor with two sets of wheels. I guess that's in case gravity changes or something. But look what's over there. Hey buddy, what's up? Well, he looks kind of sad. And over there, some narrow gauge tank engines. And a bunch of turkeys. Okay, gobbler, go for it. Thank you for the sound bite. One more. Thanks again. All right, enough. No more showing off. Over here, another creature of sorts. I guess he's got the itch. Works for me. Okay, time to do some picking. Which of these old cars should I pick? If I was a picker. They both could use a lot of work, though. And more over here. Heavy pickers are watching this. And over here, our obligatory llama. I've captured a lot of llamas this year in other videos. Now settle in and see what's happening. Any apples here? No apples this time, okay. Well, thank you.
Okay.
Wow, nice to be here again. don't have any people here who we know from 20 years ago. But I gotta check out a couple of things. That deer is still there. It's been there since the early 90s, almost 25 years. Just like the moose head. They used to carry Indian beads here. But nowadays they're made in Japan, as that song says. Wow. A redneck's delight. Now speak of the devil, look who it is. Indian cycles. Another big with pickers. All kinds of cool stuff on the wall, too. I'll take all those.
Two tracks.
There you go, just for me. Stores like this are great. They sell everything. They sell both pipes and pantyhose, whatever you need. I love places like this. Selling real hardware, not the phony stuff you get in the big city. Over there, stuff for your car. Even a place to rest. Rock back and forth like Granny.
Yeah.
All right, Granny, see you later. Say hi to Jed. Okay, pipes and pantyhose. What do you need? Now for the junk food. We'll be on our way again. Well, some Indian beads.
That's all.
But still thought they were all made in Japan.
588.
So thanks for getting that. I don't think
cool slogan.
I didn't pay that much for it last time.
I know this time it did go for like 7-something, but...
Okay. We're almost out of here. We used to visit here like every other week back in the 80s and 90s. We're always here.
Yeah, she could tell it hasn't been so long.
Oh, well, okay. Thank you.
Last time we were here, someone knew us. I one time used to hang out here, believe it or not, in my younger days. Right, let's go open the door. Yeah, we're out of here. Time to continue west. And back on the road. I'm about to wind up Laurel Mountain. Got some tight ones here on this stretch of road. But I'm getting her done. Now almost 5:30. There we come, 229 miles. I guess I'll begin the return trip soon. In fact, here we begin our return trip. I'll go north on 26 and begin making my way back towards Maryland. Our furthestmost point is right here. Our mileage going out is 232 miles. Let's see what it is going back over this route, which should be a bit faster. And now just after 5:30, 5:40, something like that. Now arriving at a place called Tunnelton. So named because there are railroad tunnels that go beneath the hill we just crossed. line down there. CSX, formerly a B&O. That's their Cincinnati line. Now there's a station, which we'll soon have a close look at. And there it is, on a brick side road. Behind it, the freight station. And now we're trackside by the former B&O station here in Tunnelton. In that direction, southwest would be Cincinnati. About 400 miles. And over there, the freight station. But here to the left is my claim to fame, although it's now abandoned. This is the former right-of-way of the one-time West Virginia Northern Railroad, abandoned 1999. But I'm one of the few people who have footage of this line in operation. I'm the only person who's got footage of the line into downtown Kingwood. There you go. Still a shame to see it abandoned like that. I'm going down in history for making a video of this line that no longer exists. The interchange is still left. That's a bit of track over here. Part of the former WVN track right there. But that's it. There in the bushes it ends. And the rest got pulled up in 1999. But my DVD is out, and you can order it. That single track is the pre-1905 line. The double track here on the left is the post-1905 line. And again, the station. And back on the road. And one time there were tracks down there. Now they're gone. That's my claim to fame back there. And now it's all gone. Now arriving in Kingwood, the former home base of the West Virginia Northern, but no longer. And I have the only footage of the train using the downtown spur. And it's uploaded for your viewing pleasure. He's picking up eastbound Route 7 here to get back towards Maryland, back towards Garrett County again. Now that we're facing east, lighting should be better with the sun behind me. And we'll soon ascend that mountain you see there. And up ahead, maybe cross the Cheat River. Okay, I gotta paddle up this here mountain. But again, typical of the roads out here, grades and curves. And now we're stopped by a wayside along a relieved curve in the road. We've been stopping here since 1982, so we can't break tradition. Nice area, though. And apparently got the Lions Club maintaining this. Nice of them. Too many bikers today. You've been stopping here for quite some time. Ever since the old days. Here is an example featuring her. She hasn't changed a bit, has she? I'm now back on the road again. I'm passing through Terra Alta. There was a B&O station in this town too, but it burnt down about 15 years ago. What a shame. But I have photos of it. And the pier, part of the wide track once crossed the road, but long abandoned, part of the grade down there. I believe it crossed right up here. But long taken out. Back in the early 80s, I believe they took out the Y. But what'll come up right here someplace on a cross like that or whatever? As close as I can tell. Terra Alta. That's Latin for high ground. Although here we're in a valley, we're not really that high up. Apparently just crossed state lines. Just saw a sign that said Maryland Route 39. I guess back in our home state. We still got miles to go though, before back to our side of the mountain. Back in Garrett County, Maryland's Great Northwest. And up here, back in Oakland, north on US 219, a road that we passed earlier. But I gotta make a couple of pit stops before going home. There, and up there at the yellow sign. Did our pit stop, and now departing. A little after 7 p.m. right now, as we head back. That's the far return trip mileage is about 39 miles. The day's mileage so far, 271. I added another couple hundred to that for the return trip home. I won't be showing too much of the return trip here because you've seen this in previous videos. So I'll be skipping around, so to speak. Over there is Deep Creek Lake. A popular spot this time of year. And up here we cross it. On a bridge built in 1988. Well, completed 88. They began in 86. I have a video of this bridge being constructed. And now passing through a place called Accident. As I keep saying, I can't make up stuff like this. I believe a couple hundred years back there was a mine explosion in a mine to the west of here, to the left. And hence the name Accident. Of the Alleghenies there. We're not going to get back to our side of the Alleghenies. I guess I can click my heels three times and keep repeating, there's no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. I can't do that But I can't pick up the freeway and beeline back to Baltimore. We'll pick up 68, which will take us to I-70. Once again, Negro Mountain. And others as well. But now departing Garrett County, they're coming into Cumberland, the Queen City of the Alleghenies. I took a nice shot of that once, back in the 80s. Down there, CSX. Around 8:15 p.m. right now, as we start to lose some light, and as we approach the Sidley Hill Cut in the mist. Here's the cut close up. I made a video of this last year, 2016. And more misty mountains. It's supposed to rain later. Now in the Hancock area, Maryland's narrowest point. Only 2.5 miles wide between Pennsylvania to the left and West Virginia to the right. Maryland's narrowest point. Picking up I-70 for the rest of the return trip. About 8:35 right now. Got 105 miles left to go. About 105. Time lapse again in the Hagerstown area. Still losing light. Well, I guess it's obvious. And up there, our last mountain crossing, Catoctin Mountain again, which you crossed earlier. But at what point do I click my heels? I begin repeating, there's no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. There is no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. There ain't no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. There's no place like the hood. Oh, I'm back. We're back. About 10:05 right now. But on the road, it's 10:45 this morning, give or take. And today, both the trip out and the trip back are about equidistant. About 235 miles both ways. I mean, each way, that is. We got a grand total of about 469, according to my odometer. Almost 500 miles. Sounds like a song. Yep. Your bullfrog is back, and I did it again. I was about out of practice, I guess you can tell by some of my narration being off. But it's been 6 months, you cannot be out of practice for a bit. Alright friends, hope you enjoyed. I'll try to bring another one whenever I can.
There's no place like home.